TritonAthletics.com. Tim McKinney, live from the multi-purpose field here on the beautiful Triton College campus in River Grove, Illinois, as it's now time for the big one for us here as the Trojans are set to take on Anoka-Ramsey Community College in the second semifinal of this NJCAA Division III Midwest District Tournament. The winner will take on Richland College out of Dallas. They were a 1-0 winner in our first game of the day as they defeated Schoolcraft here earlier this afternoon. The field looks in marvelous shape. Great job by our baseball team in particular, getting the field cleared. 43 degrees is our temperature on this Friday afternoon. And we'll see what the Trojans can do. They're ranked number 6 in the nation. They're 18-1 on the year. Anoka-Ramsey, on the other hand, they come in 9-5-1. These two teams played 2 years ago in the district semifinals in Minnesota in St. Paul. Triton won that one by the score of 3-1. We're about 5 minutes away from getting the lineups and the anthem going. But in the meantime, yesterday I had a chance to chat with Triton head coach Peter Sueva to preview today's matchup. And welcome to the Triton College YouTube channel and TritonAthletics.com. Big day of soccer, Midwest District Tournament. The Trojans will be getting set to take on Anoka-Ramsey Community College out of Coon Rapids, Minnesota. And joining me prior to the game, head coach of the Trojans, Peter Sueva. And Peter, first of all, congratulations on winning the Region 4 title against Harper. It was a very dramatic game.
Thank you. Definitely, I mean, to win it in overtime, it was a great game for anybody to watch. So it's even better we won it with 3 minutes left in overtime.
Especially against a rival like Harper, it was really an intense game.
Oh, definitely. I mean, we've battled them for years. They've always been 1-2 with us. Even this year, they only lost one game to us, and then they lost the second one. So it feels great to beat them to move on.
Talk about just the emotions of that game. You guys were down most of the way. Alex was able to get the game tying goal, and then Marson, who we'll be talking to a little bit later on in our broadcast, with the game winner. But just the ups and downs, the emotions of that game.
I mean, I think the weather kind of dictated that game because we're more of a possession team, but it was really wet, so we couldn't really possess the ball. So we had to change the way we played. It kind of suited them better because they play more direct. But yeah, going down 1-0 definitely was a shock for us because we haven't really been down all season. But we responded really well. And then in overtime, it's whoever steps up and makes the first mistake, I guess. And they made a mistake down the line, and Machin came in and put it in.
Talked about weather. It's definitely going to be a factor this weekend. We've had sleet, snow, everything. How's that going to factor in as you guys prepare for this game?
I mean, there's snow on the ground right now, so hopefully it melts by then. But the field will be wet and slick, so it might not suit us, but we'll try to play through it.
Is it more of a mental hurdle, you think, for the players, the playing conditions like this, or just being here at home, getting a little acquainted to it? Will that help toward the team's advantage, you think?
I mean, I don't think anybody's used to playing in snow. Or, I mean, the weather's going to be definitely cold. I think our guys went through it last week, so they should be used to it. We've practiced outside most of the week in this weather, so I think we'll be ready.
Let's talk about the opponent today, Anoka-Ramsey. We're familiar with them. We were out there a couple of years ago in St. Paul in districts, won 3-1, but obviously it's a different year, different team. I know you had a chance to see a little bit of them on tape. What are your thoughts about them?
They're definitely strong. They have a bunch of big guys, and they're fast, so it's going to be a struggle since we have a pretty small team, but I think we could beat them through the possession.
Plus, it has to be exciting to have this district tournament on the home field.
Oh, it's the first time we're hosting it with four teams. It should be a great event for everybody to come and watch really good teams because you have some of the top teams in the country at one place at the same time.
All right, well, Peter, thanks for your time. Good luck today. We're looking forward to a great game. Head coach Peter Sueva of the Triton College men's soccer team joining us here. Stick around. We're going to have Triton taking on Anoka-Ramsey in a few moments here live on the Triton College YouTube channel.
I chose a career in nursing because I am passionate about helping people, about healing them. I chose Triton because their teachers are professionals with real-world experience, and they're always willing to go the extra mile to help. This is so much more than reading from a textbook. I am getting hands-on experience, caring for patients, inside and out. And the support I receive from my classmates makes a huge difference. We're all here to help and support each other. I know that I'll be ready to provide the very best care possible to patients because I'm working with the same equipment and technology used by the area's top hospitals. My Triton College education has prepared me well. I'm ready to put my education to work and make a difference in my patients' lives as well as my own.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Triton College for today's second semifinal of this 2019 NJCAA Division III Midwest District Men's Soccer Tournament. Our second semifinal will feature the visitors on the scoreboard, the Rams of the Anoka-Ramsey on the Rapids, Minnesota, versus your home team on the scoreboard, the Trojans of Triton College. Before we meet the lineups for today's match, I ask you to please rise and face the flag to the left of the scoreboard as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Now let's meet the starters for this afternoon's district semifinal. First one on the Ramsey, in goal, Devin Thompson. Number three, Radwan Alame. Number four, Leon Townsend. Number seven, Gerson Maldonado Garcia. Number nine, Gabriel Monahan. Number 14, Felipe Barbosa. Number 15, Jordan Pierce. Number six, Dennis Salinas. Number 22, Dawson Penner. Number 23, Bills Goldranson. And number 25, Brian Alexander. The head coach of the Rams is Brady Hicks, assisted by Ben Harrison, Luke Banners, and Alex Alvarez. Now let's meet the starters for your Triton College Trojans. In goal, Peter Pez. Number three, Marcin Kiera. Number seven, Fernando Alvarado. Number 10, Christopher Wojcicki. Number 15, Jacob Krunek. Number 18, Arnel Sinajic. Number 22, Hector Anguiano. Number 23, Michael Savarsky. Number 24, Evan Cole. And number 25, Alex Menzik. The head coach of the Trojans in his eighth season, Peter Sweva, assisted by Maciek Orlowski. Good luck to both teams.
So the stage has been set, and we're just about set. The Trojans and the home whites, the black numerals. The pinstripe look for Anoka-Ramsey, the blue and gold. And again, the winner will face Richland for the district title here tomorrow afternoon at 1:30 here at Triton. Trojans come in 18-1 on the year. They've won their last 15 games in a row. Very dramatic. Double overtime win to clinch the regional title versus Harper here on Saturday, 2-1 the final. 43 degrees on this Friday afternoon, and we're underway here in River Grove. Lights are on, partly mostly cloudy skies, and again, a great job by our baseball team and everyone here at the school to get the field in great shape for this game here today. And we'll see how quick Triton has been known for attacking quickly this season. They've had some early goals throughout the postseason, and we'll see what happens here early on. Again, these teams played a couple years ago in St. Paul. Trojans won that game by a final of 3-1. So the ball goes out the center, and it's controlled by the Trojans. Evan Cole gets it out ahead for Alvarado. Alvarado looking to make a break. Fires and misses wide. So first shot attempt for the Trojans. A minute in. It'll be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey by Thompson. Richland scored with 10 minutes to go to win their game. They'll get the winner of this one here tomorrow. Battle at center, and the foul called, and Triton will control. Fired in by Marcin Kieta. He was the Region 4 tournament MVP. Had the game winner in the 107th minute Saturday. Good chance out in front for Mezik, but it's controlled by Anoka-Ramsey, by Barbosa. Goes out of play. The Anoka-Ramsey throw-in by Alwanen. And touch last by the Rams. Throw in for Triton. Cole will put it in play. Alvarado trying to battle for it, but it's eventually controlled by Chris Majewski, the MVP. Well, I would say not quite MVP, but he's likely, well, right there for the region, but he's going to be right on the top of the list. He's an All-American nominee along with Peter Pez at goal for the Trojans this season. Another foul near center, and this time called on Triton. And Anoka-Ramsey will take control. Anoka-Ramsey hasn't played for a while. Oh, deep strike, and that's in. From way out there off the free kick, and Anoka-Ramsey with the early goal. Unbelievable. That was from well over 30 yards out. And just like that, I talked about the quick strike ability of Triton, but it's the visitors with the first goal. Felipe Barbosa with that goal for Anoka-Ramsey. Wow, that is a momentum stopper early on. And that was just a clean strike, and Pez dove for it, but that's just a beautifully placed by Barbosa. His sixth goal of the year. Actually, his fifth goal. He had five assists entering play today. And Anoka-Ramsey hasn't played for a few weeks, but no signs of rust by the visitors here early on. So it'll be a Triton goal kick. So we'll see if the Trojans can regroup here. They fell behind Saturday 1-0 versus Harper, and were able to come back and win that game. They're going to have to play from behind here in this semifinal game. Evan Cole with it along the near side. Headed in, but Kieta couldn't get anything on it. But the Trojans do maintain possession. Safarski. Reyes. Now Majewski, the cross is wide, trying to get chased down there in the corner. And it'll be touched last by Anoka-Ramsey. Triton will throw it in. Kieta. Now with some space, they go wide to Cole. Cole looking to get one inside the box, but it's kicked back out by Anoka-Ramsey. And now Triton will play it out and regroup. Played a little more than 5 minutes. Majewski looking, but it's cleared back out by Anoka-Ramsey. Trojans looking to maintain control. It's headed back by Safarski. Now Evan Cole with it. Goes out wide for Bojewski, and he's tackled, and it's going to be throw in for the Trojans near the corner. Chris, the leading scorer for the Trojans, top five in the nation in scoring. And a foul on the Trojans, and this will be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. Trojans will just back it out again. And that pass upfield, kicked out of play by Anoka-Ramsey. So Barbosa to early strike for the Rams. That's what you want to do when you're the visiting team. You get on the board early, take away what momentum that the Trojans have getting to play this game here at home. Triton looking to set things up outside, converging in. So we're going to have a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. Getting that clear strike, Barbosa. That probably been about almost 40 yards out. Another whistle. And we have a foul on Anoka-Ramsey, and it'll be a free kick for the Trojans from almost about the same distance where Anoka-Ramsey got their goal. Long drive in front of the net, and it is recovered by Thompson. Bobbled it momentarily, but was able to hang on. A little bit more than 9 minutes gone by in this opening half. The Trojans are trailing 1-0 in this district semifinal game. Pez is going to slide and dive to get that one before it went out of play, and he'll get the goal kick. Near center to battle for the ball. It's going to be controlled by Alwanen for Anoka-Ramsey, and he'll get the throw in. And it goes straight to Alex Mezik for Triton. Evan Cole, the Mojewski. Battle along that near side. Safarski. Triton looking to attack here. Long ball deep, but will be cleared back out of play by Anoka-Ramsey. Minutes left in this opening half. But again, if for those of you who are watching us and haven't been with us all day, this whole field was covered with snow this morning, 7 a.m. And our guys did a great job getting the snow cleared, getting the bleachers cleared. You see some of the remnants of the snow as Pez picks the ball up from what's left of some of the small mountains of snow that were shoveled off the field from earlier today. Sun actually peaked out for a little bit, but it's going to start getting a little bit more cooler as this afternoon progresses. Safarski will get it out of play, and it'll be a throw-in for Anoka-Ramsey. Triton will get a throw in. But Anoka-Ramsey able to regain control of the ball. They have those nice announcer-friendly pinstripe uniforms, but their numbers are camouflaged in between, so we'll pick up their numbers as they go along here. Hieta will get it cleared out ahead. Ran down by Coonrat. But Anoka-Ramsey regains control at center. 1-0 Rams with the lead. That one punched back out toward the other end, and Pez will gobble it up easily. There'll be a goal kick for, actually, he's not going to kick it, he's just going to roll it out and back into play. Did that pretty quickly. Attack here for the Rams. And a couple bodies down, one each way, and they'll play on. Alvarado trying to battle for it on that far side. Headed out by Triton. And then more bodies jump out to try and head that one in a collision. And the ball will be awarded to the Trojans. Richland will await the winner. And they had a late score versus Schoolcraft with about 10 minutes to go. And won that one 1-0. They're number one in the nation coming into this tournament. Richland, Triton, ranked sixth in the nation. Pretty much have been ranked the entire year, but rankings won't mean much if you can't get the job done and win this game here. Anoka-Ramsey with the early goal. Kieta's shot attempt was blocked. Triton able to maintain possession. Far side, not much going there for Anguiano. But the Trojans will get the throw in. Into Alvarado. Alvarado now looking to set up for Cole. Shot was deflected out of play. Thompson will put it back in play for Anoka-Ramsey. Trojans get the ball right back. Cole. Now good surge ahead, ooh, but Alvarado wasn't able to quite get a foot on that one to maintain the dribble. And it goes out of play. And Anoka-Ramsey will get the throw in. Under 30 minutes to go here in the opening half. 1-0 Anoka-Ramsey. Midwest District semifinal game. Winner of this tournament will go on to the Division III National Tournament in Herkimer, New York. Long ball out ahead. Some contact, but everything was let go. There is Anoka-Ramsey. Tried to make a good play deep in on that attempt. But Pez will kick it out towards center field. But it's controlled. Alwanen. But it's ran down by now Sinagic for the Trojans. Got to get a push here offensively if you're Triton, trailing here 1-0. Kunrick was looking to move in, but couldn't get anything going. Safarski out wide to Cole. Cole across, it's scooped up by Thompson. gets it way beyond center. Boy, that's a big, nice kick there by him, but it goes right to his counterpart, Peter Paz, on the other end for Triton. And he'll just get it out quickly for Triton to attack. Near 27 minutes to go here in this opening half. So the Rams will get a throw in here. But the Trojans get the takeaway. And again, looking to attack quickly. Ball out ahead for Majewski. But Anoka-Ramsey able to take it right back. Here they come. Gobranson with it. Gobranson on the attack. Has some space. Shot saved by Pez. Ball loose. Still out in front. And a goal. Pez unable to control it. And Gobranson able to get a second crack at it. Puts it away, and it's 2-0 Anoka-Ramsey. Wow. You got to control that ball as the goalie. You give up that rebound. Just a couple of golden chances there, and the Rams are able to cash in. So Gobranson with the goal. Sophomore, and this is not the start we were looking for. Well, there is some precedent with Triton being down 2-0. They were down 2-0 in their first game of the year at Elgin and rallied to win that one in overtime, 3-2. Today's a much more different situation, but you got to give the visitors from Coon Rapids, Minnesota credit. They have come out and they have played a very solid game here early on. Gobranson, that's his team leading 14th goal of the year. Two to nothing, Anoka-Ramsey. Now Triton will have to be really aggressive here now, trailing Bow by 2 goals. Shot is wide. That attempt by Didier Reyes. Thompson will have the goal kick as we've nearly played 20 minutes. 2-0 Rams in a bit of a shocker here early from the multi-purpose field. But again, sometimes you just never know how these matchups are when you have these teams from different regions. Especially, you know, just wipe out the record. Just anything can happen this time of year. Trojans able to get control. Coonrick along the far side, but Anoka-Ramsey got it right back. Kieta was able to block it away. And now if you're Anoka-Ramsey, up 2-0, you got a cushion to work with. You want to be a little bit more defensive.
Can't keep dropping. Can't keep
pack things in a little bit, kind of just not let, don't want to let Triton get the next goal, try and kill as much time as you can now since you have the lead to work with. But again, the way they're playing, they could be a little aggressive here, try and go for more. But they don't want to try and let Triton right back into this one to get some momentum back, or at least try and get some momentum period in this game, I should say. And it's an easy save for Thompson. So a couple years ago, it was Triton who won on the home field of Anoka-Ramsey. Actually, we played the game at the Concordia University in St. Paul. Triton, the first time to get to host a district tournament like this here on campus. This field was built in 2016, and for many years we had the grass field across the street, so events like this we never had really here on campus for soccer because our old field wasn't regulation size and we would have to play elsewhere. So to be here on campus for the first time for a big marquee event like this, big for the school, big for the program, but so far the early results are not very good here for the Trojans on the scoreboard. And Bujeski is fouled, and Penner got a piece of him. And we'll see if the Trojans can make something happen off this set piece. Shot attempt goes wide by Reyes. It'll be a goal kick. For Anoka-Ramsey, he'll just get it out into play. But we do have a whistle. And we'll hit the reset button and try it again. Cole looking to push it. Got to push the tempo up. Out wide, Pasula's in. That shot attempt is blocked. Well, Pasula's in off the bench. You got to try and find some energy from someone here being down. Out of the corner. Tried to play it back to Chieta, but nothing generated off of that for Triton. Rojewski, and that one able to roll right easily to Thompson. We're under 20 minutes to go here in this first half. The visitors from Minnesota have a 2-0 lead. Throw in for the Rams. And with a 2-0 lead. They just want to let this clock keep on rolling and maintain as much possession as they can. Triton trailing, needing to push the pace, push the tempo. Really, I think if you're Triton, just to get some momentum your way, you at least got to get one of these goals back before halftime, I would think. Just to change the mentality going into the locker room. But we've seen the Trojans score quickly and score in spurts throughout the season. Ball ahead, but Majeski, oh! Had a chance there, but Thompson was able to jump high to bring it down. Anoka-Ramsey now will play it back, trying to maintain control. But they give it away, Cole with it. And that's touched out last by Wabe for Anoka-Ramsey, a Triton throw-in. Under 18 minutes to go here, first half. Some open space for the Trojans to work with here. See if they can make something happen. Boy in front, but they couldn't get a clean look. So that was Montaduce McCulloch, who's now in the game as well for the Trojans. Anoka-Ramsey able to maintain and get that possession right back. Ball was played nicely there by Gonzalez to stop the run for the Trojans. Here for Gulbranson, but offsides will be the call against the Rams. Two to nothing, Anoka-Ramsey. Barbosa, the early goal, and then Gulbranson, the second goal. 14th minute. Cole. Up the line, the Mojewski cross. Good chance here. Trojans can't get a shot off. That's cleared downfield. Gulbranson will run it down. Gulbranson outside the box. Good dribble, the leading score for the Rams, but excellent defense there by Triton to take it right away. Got to generate something here if you're the Trojans. Cole to Chieta. But again, cleared back out near center by Anoka-Ramsey. Barbosa. But then he loses it quickly. Chieta. Touch last by Wabe. Cole with the throw in. Little jostling there. Now Cole looking. And it's headed by Pasula. And there's the handball called. Trojans will get the free kick. Sinanagic with the free kick. Safarski trying to run it down. And it will be a throw-in for Anoka-Ramsey. We're under 14 minutes to go here in this first half. Trojans trying to get something going, but well defended by the Rams. Wind picking up a bit. We've had all different kinds of weather conditions these last few soccer games we've had here. The rain Saturday, to the snow the last couple of days. Now it's just cold and windy. And Anoka-Ramsey will get a throw in. Rams lead it 2-0 here, first half. Winner will get Richland in the championship. Richland played the tortoise and hare game of Schoolcraft, and Schoolcraft slowed it down and packed it in, but the Richland was able to get the one goal late. That shot attempt goes wide, and Triton will put it back in play, trailing by 2 goals. Again, I think it would be pretty key if, you know, I mean, there's plenty of time left, but I just think if you're Triton, you just would love to get one of these back here before halftime. Had some good possession down there and offensively, but haven't been able to get much going to challenge Thompson in goal. Thompson's made a couple decent stops so far. Call wide. Center shot, save Thompson, and he gets down on it. Well, there was his best test of the day, and he passed it with flying colors to Devin Thompson. Beautiful save right there. We near 11 minutes to go here in the first half. Was Reyes with that shot attempt for the Trojans. Probably their best look of the match thus far. Kieta out to Wojcicki. And that one headed back out by the Rams. And out of play will be a throw in for Triton. Cole gets it in. Wojcicki in the corner, cross.
Come to the box, boys! Dawson!
Now the Trojans will reset here offensively. In the box for Kieta, but it's headed back out by the Rams, and they clear it. 10 minutes to go here in this first half, 2-0, Anoka-Ramsey. Coming up at halftime, we'll have a conversation we taped yesterday with Marcin Kieta of the Trojans out of Lane Tech. Marcin, freshman, was the Region 4 tournament MVP, had the game-winning goal against Harper Saturday. Trojans got to keep the pressure on here. Eventually, you would think something will break through here. Mezek will just get it back out to Pez, and the Trojans will regroup. Cole throws it in. Gets it back. Long to near side. But still pinned along that near side are the Trojans, and they'll try once again. Cole into Chieta. Chieta looking for some space underneath for Pasula. But it will be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. If you're Triton being down 2-0, you got to take some risk. Chieta. He'll get the ball back. Can he get a shot? No, he does. He's kind of pinned quickly. Did try to get something off there, but well defended once again by Anoka-Ramsey. But it was good enough to force a corner kick for the Trojans. Trojans have put some more pressure on, but nothing to show for it here on the scoreboard. Nearing 7 minutes left in the half. Corner kick Trojans. In the box at one, controlled by Triton Safarski. Trying to put a play on it. Maybe trying to force another corner, but well defended by Anoka-Ramsey to get it out of trouble. Taboy there on the near side, and it'll be a throw-in for the Rams. Penner.
Drop, Dawson, drop.
But that pass goes right to Triton. Chieta. But then he's not able to get anything, as that one was deflected by Anoka-Ramsey, and we're going to have a foul and a stoppage here, a play, and this may be our first infraction of the afternoon. And the yellow card has been issued. So Brandon Gonzalez gets issued with the red card, or the yellow card, excuse me, for Anoka-Ramsey. Six minutes to go in the half. Rams able to regain control. Gobranson gets it out ahead. Good chance there, but well defended by the Trojans. Sinanagic there defending. Player is still down for Anoka-Ramsey, and now we will get the stoppage for the injury. 5:43 remaining here in this first half. Anoka-Ramsey 2, Triton nothing in this Midwest District semifinal game. Richland awaits the winner. So Lucy Wash, our trainer, will come out onto the field. They'll attend to the injured Ram. now. At least he's somewhat back up, now getting back up on his feet. So once the injured Ram player makes his way off the field, we'll resume play shortly. That was Barbosa, who got the first goal, who's the injured player. Some good sportsmanship there by Sinanagic for Triton to pat him on the side as he makes his way off the field, helped off by our trainer, Lucy Wong. So play resumes. Five and a half minutes and counting. Trojans are trailing 2-0. Lucas Mordarski now in there, number 12 for the Trojans. He's along the near side with Cole as he throws it in. Wide, Kieta looking to get control near the corner, maybe trying to force a corner, but he does attempt the cross. It's headed out by the Rams, but it goes right to Cole. And the Trojans will backpedal here just slightly and regroup. Well, talking with Coach Peter Sweva, what they saw on film of this Anoka-Ramsey team, they were very impressed with them. So they knew they were going to have their hands full today, but still, I think it's a little bit of a shock to the system being down 2-0 here on the scoreboard. Trojans played back towards center. Mezik to Cole. Cole converged quickly by Alwanen. Cole had a little bit of a run along the sideline, but it'll end up being a throw-in for Anoka-Ramsey. Alwanen will throw it in. And it goes right to the Trojans, Safarski. But deflected back out, Anoka-Ramsey with it now. So we near 3 minutes remaining here before halftime. Now here's a chance. Call out in front. Evan Cole, not able to get a shot off. Well defended again by Anoka-Ramsey. Boy, that was a good chance right there. Cole unable to pull the trigger. Anoka-Ramsey with control of the ball and a 2-0 lead. Difficult first half here for the Trojans. Team's going to have to regroup at halftime. Again, they've had games they've been down before. Most notably, really, they've led a lot of their games this year, being 18-1. But the one game they were down early, as I mentioned once before was that Elgin game was a 2-0 deficit. They actually were down 2-0 in that one with about 25 minutes to play before getting the two goals late to force overtime before Marcin Kieta got the game win. 90 seconds left in this first half. At some point, you got to just fire it at the net and see what Thompson can do. That one headed to Thompson for the easy save. Had that one challenge off the Reyes shot that he was able to stop. A minute to go in the half. Anoka-Ramsey for the 2-0 lead will take their time here. Bell Branson, but had it taken away. Kieta, the long ball ahead. Can Wojcicki run it down? He won't be able to do so. Thompson comes up and he'll pick it up. 30 seconds left here in the first half. Branson, now Wanen in the corner, cross, and that's headed out by Triton, and that should take care of the first half. And the horn sounds, we reached halftime. Tough first half for the Trojans. They're going to have to figure out a way to get some offense going in the second half. As the first goal was scored in the first 5 minutes by Barbosa. Then Gobranson added the second goal for Anoka-Ramsey in the 14th minute. And it's the visitors from Coon Rapids, Minnesota, enjoying a 2-0 lead over Triton here at halftime of the semifinal game of this Midwest District Tournament. So we're going to pause from the live action. Come back shortly for second half play. In the meantime, we have an interview we taped with Marcin Kieta yesterday of the Triton men's soccer team. Have that interview, enjoy it. We'll be back in about 14 minutes for the second half. 2-0, Anoka-Ramsey has the lead.
And welcome back to the Triton College YouTube channel. Halftime of this district semifinal between Triton and Anoka-Ramsey. Hope you're enjoying the ball game so far. And joining us, our special guest, the MVP of the Region 4 tournament, Marcin Kieta. He had the game-winning goal. He's no stranger to game-winning goals because I remember the one you had to start the season against Elgin. That was a very dramatic win, and then you come back and get the game-winner here on Saturday versus Harper. Just talk about that moment. Talk about that feeling.
Well, I mean, the feeling was unbelievable. Harper's a great team. Give credit to them, but like we were down 1-0 to start the game, came back to tie it, and it was a very fast-paced game, and just to get that goal in overtime was an unbelievable feeling.
Talk about the intensity of the game, because they did jump out, take the early lead. They beat us at Triton. You guys won at Harper. So just the rivalry in that game in itself, it just felt like everybody was just into that ball game.
Oh, yeah, I mean, definitely. Going into the game was very tense. I mean, they beat us at home 3-0. We beat them at their home 4-0. So there's obviously just that little bit of history right there of us beating each other at each other's own place. But, yeah, going into the game, it was very, very intense, very fast-paced and aggressive from both sides.
Seems like, as Coach said earlier, they made a little bit of a mistake. Talk about what you saw on the game-winning goal.
Well, I mean, Chris, when he got the ball out wide, I just kind of saw that he was going to take it down the line. And something just felt magical about that moment. I just felt that if I sprint into the box, a little luck would come my way, which it did. And then as it was served in, just redirected it with my thigh and went in.
Now you guys are potentially now 2 wins away from a national tournament. Of course, step one is Anoka-Ramsey. Weather will be a factor. Have you even played in potential, it's snowing all week, any conditions close to what we've had here the last few days?
Well, I mean, today we actually had a training session in the morning, so we got out there, we played a little bit, got used to the conditions, nothing too crazy, but just getting familiar with it, because I mean, it's definitely going to be different. It's going to be slick, it's going to be cold, icy, so we definitely have to adjust to that.
I know, kind of mean with the group and the team, and kind of as you guys collectively as a team, what do you feel the mindset is heading into this tournament?
I think the biggest thing is just working hard and working for each other. I mean, that's kind of been the theme since day one of the season, just working hard for each other, staying positive, and just making the most of every opportunity that we get. Whether that's guys who are starting, guys coming off the bench, it's a complete team effort.
Just one question, a little sidebar, a little bit about your experience as a student here at Triton. How have you enjoyed your time here? How has that been like for you?
Oh, definitely. I mean, class-wise, everything, just there's a lot of people, there's a lot of resources to help you out. And for the most part, it's been very manageable. Coaches are very understanding of prioritizing education as well as soccer. So it's been a great experience.
Guys are getting close. I know it has to be very exciting. Marson, good luck. Best of luck. We're looking forward to some great things. Hopefully, maybe not too much suspense. Now, we don't mean want another double overtime. I don't know if our hearts can take it, but great job. Congratulations so far. Good luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Marson Kieden, Region 4 Tournament MVP, our special guest. Stick around. We'll have second half action coming up right after this between Triton and Anoka-Ramsey live on the Triton College YouTube channel.
Criminal justice field is growing every year. Many of our students want to be police officers, but I probably get an equal number that are interested in corrections and probation and parole and victims advocacy and social work. The field is extensive. Automatically, people think criminal justice and they think law enforcement. That's not all there is to it. I want everyone to know that our program here is a criminal justice program, not a police program. You're going to get a little bit of everything. So that way you become a more fulfilled, well-rounded candidate for any agency that you decide to go apply for.
The reason I got interested in criminal justice is because of all the current events that have been going on, with all the stuff that's been going on in courts, the debates, politics. I want to know a little bit more why stuff get decided, why is there certain stuff happening. Joining the criminal justice program in Triton College made me understand 100% of what's going on out there and why certain stuff happens.
Everyone in this program are what we call practitioners, either current or former criminal justice professionals. The education that you receive here will be much different than in a criminal justice program where the instructors are simply instructors and don't have the background and experience that we have.
The one-on-one experience, the classroom environment, the teacher, professor to student ratio is comfortable. And you can verbally speak with the teachers and they explain the work. You use Blackboard. There's other people here to help you. If there's any issues with computers, there's a lab. There's just so many opportunities and options open to new students here and continuing education students.
The instructors do help us out a lot. I mean, there's a bulletin board at the bottom of our building where there are many job offers, whereas you can either be a police officer, part-time police officer, a dispatcher, a security, and currently I'm trying my best to get into TSA, and the instructors have been wonderful with tips, and it's just an amazing experience for me here.
In the criminal justice field, we see at least a 5% growth in law enforcement over the next 10 years, a 5 to 7% growth in corrections, and even higher than that in the social services end, victims advocacy, child advocates, and social work. We think that the criminal justice field is a unique opportunity for a lot of people, including young women. It is one of the only jobs where we believe there's not a glass ceiling. The same qualifications for a man qualifies for a woman, the same pay for a man as for a woman. I hope you enjoyed this video. Are you ready to come and join us at Triton College?
And welcome back to the multi-purpose field on the campus of Triton College in River Grove. Tim McKinney, great to have you all with us here today. Dimitri, the brains of the operation, running all the controls. And we thank you all for being with us here on the Triton College YouTube channel or on TritonAthletics.com, however you found us today. Trojans got some work to do, trailing this one 2-0 versus Anoka-Ramsey. Barbosa the early goal, and then goal Branson scored about 10 minutes after the Barbosa goal. But I think just Triton has been able to put some pressure on. They did late in that first half, but you just got to get some shots at the net. That's kind of really what you got to do. You got to challenge Thompson a little bit more than what they had. The one time they did challenge him, he did make a great save. So the second half is underway, and we'll see if the Trojans can mount yet another comeback in them. They did it on Saturday, but they were down a goal on Saturday. Of course, Triton in the white. Anoka-Ramsey in the pinstripe blue and gold. And we'll see if the Trojans come out with a little more sense of urgency here in this second half. They're attacking from our right to left. And a foul called. Thompson will put it in play. Headed out back towards center by the Trojans. Some contact there, and Alvarado went down. But Triton will be able to put it in play. But they're going to have to force the issue here. Kieta, the deep ball. And it is stopped by Thompson. Went right to him. That free kick just not in the box, maybe a little bit too deep for the Trojans to make a play on it. And the wind helped carry that ball out of play. Quick throw in by the Trojans by Kunrek. Back out the center, controlled by Triton by Sinanagic. Cole trying to chase it down, but cannot do so. And it'll be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. It's 3 minutes gone by here in this second half. Triton trailing 2-0. Winner will get Richland in the championship game. We'll be back here at Triton tomorrow at 1:30. Game will be streamed live on the Triton College YouTube channel. Thompson, as again, Anoka-Ramsey is playing the ball back. Just you want to kill some time. Again, they're up 2-0. They don't have to be that aggressive on their end, but they just don't want to get too relaxed with the lead. Ball up ahead, ran down. Majewski has it. Now the shot! Oh, it hit off the post! It hit off the post! Reyes had a great look, and it hit the left post. Wow. Well, that's been the luck of the day for the Trojans, and now they do have a player down. Clock has stopped. 4:01 has been played in this second half. Boy, that was a golden opportunity for Triton. So after the stoppage for the injury, clock is now running again. It'll be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. And Thompson with a little low sinker. And their coach not very happy with that alignment after that goal kick. Triton able to easily retake control of it. Anguiano with it now out wide to Kunrick. Kunrick near the corner, but had no one there to help offensively, and Anoka-Ramsey able to regain control, but then they lose it back. Alvarado. And a trip inside the box. That may be a penalty kick. This may be the break the Trojans need. We'll wait for the official decision. And the clock was running. Now it's stopped. 39 minutes, 49 seconds left. And it's going to be a penalty kick for Alex Mezek. Mezek a chance to get Triton on the board. Sophomore from Lane Tech, saved by Thompson! Oh my! Thompson, an outstanding play to keep Triton scoreless and maintain the 2-0 lead for Anoka-Ramsey. So within a matter of the first 5.5 minutes of this second half, the Trojans have had a shot off the post and then a penalty kick saved by Thompson. Unbelievable. And Mezek scored off a penalty kick that got Triton on the board Saturday versus Harper, but could not repeat the story today. That's a big momentum swing right there, and that entire Anoka-Ramsey bench to our right up on their feet, and they exploded with cheers and applause off that outstanding save by Thompson. Once again, they really don't have to do much offensively, just try and possess the ball as much as they can. They're really not looking to score up 2-0. But as we sense near the late stages of the first half, the Trojans have put a little more pressure on, but still have a big goose egg on the scoreboard. Some of the folks are not happy about that one. Anoka-Ramsey will get the kick. Thompson. Look how the wind just knocks that ball down. Again, the wind blowing across from right to left, so in the second half, that wind when he kicks it from that end, it's going to get knocked down right away, just blowing right into the face of Thompson. So the Trojans do have the wind to their back in the second half, but still nothing to show for it. As we have another foul called and a little warning here by the referee. As Wojcicki will give a little lecture briefly, and we'll play on. Two to nothing, Anoka-Ramsey in this second half. Now, good defense there by Triton. Though Branson couldn't get anything. Now he'll go out wide. Outside, Pierce blocked. And the Rams will maintain possession. Maldonado Garcia. Penner. Steals. Pick up. Picked up by Maldonado Garcia. Now Triton able to play it back and they'll have control. Peter Pez. Out the Sinagic. Go Branson. Now wide. Alexander. And that one goes over the top of the net and out of play. And Pez will put it back in play for the Trojans. We play 10 minutes in this second half. Still a 2-0 Anoka-Ramsey lead in this Midwest District semifinal game. Winner will get Richland tomorrow afternoon for the championship. See the Trojan can get some pressure here now. And Guiano. Chieta. But controlled by Anoka-Ramsey. Alexander, the ball out ahead, but well defended by Safarski. Chieta. Trojans need to get something going. Alvarado, a lot of contact. Triton wanted a foul there. And now they'll get the free kick. Chieta from about 30 yards out. At some point, the Trojans have to cash in. In the middle, head it, but over the top and out of play. Goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. Wind just knocks that ball down, but he was able to make it out towards center of that kick. Triton able to control. Little pressure now put on by Anoka-Ramsey defensively there. Out of play, be a throw in for the Rams. Gerson Maldonado Garcia gets it in. Now Bojewski able to free it back out. And a little arm wrestling there and a Late shove there by Reyes, and they'll play on. Here's a chance! Oh, couldn't get a clean look. And some contact again in the box. And hold everything. The officials will sort this out. And this will be another potential penalty kick here for the Trojans. Arnell Sinadjic from Lane Tech. Another big chance for Triton. A foul in the box. The penalty kick. Good! And a goal for Triton! They're on the board! And the lead has been cut in half. It's a 2-1 game. Arnell Sinadjic, the 5'11 freshman out of Lane Tech. The penalty kick with 31 and a half minutes left. 2-1 now to score. Again, the Trojans have had a lot of chances here. They have taken control of this game in terms of controlling the pace, and they finally break through on the scoreboard. Now we'll see if that changes the strategy for Anoka-Ramsey. Their lead is now down to 1. Well, things are starting to get a little exciting now. And for Arnell, that was his first goal of the year. Had an assist for his only tally on the point sheet. And it could not have come at a better time, indeed, for the Trojans. Well, things have gotten a little more exciting now here. As we near 30 minutes to play. 2-1 now, the Triton deficit. Just had to get one on the board to get the life going, get the momentum going, get the energy going. This one's wide. Here comes Majewski. He has a chance. He fires. Scores! He scores! Majewski ties the game. 2-2. 30 minutes left. The team leading scorer, the All-American candidate, his 22nd of the year, and it's a 2-2 game. How ironic that number 22 for him, goal-wise, ties it at 2. So a minute and a half later, the Trojans have tied the game. The fire is shot out of the cannon here in this second half for Triton. And we got a lot of soccer left. A half hour of regulation. 2-2 to score. Well, you need your big players to step up. And, you know, Chris, he's not an All-American candidate. Regional MVP for a reason. You just saw that run coming, and he was able to bury it to tie the game. And now if you're Anoka-Ramsey, who had all that momentum after the Thompson save on that PK, the script has just flipped here in a heartbeat. Two, two. Well, that's what we were, a little more like it. A little more like it. Ball. Contact there. And they're going to play on and say that's on Triton that time. Everyone getting into this one now. That's what, again, you kind of sensed how Triton played toward the end of the first half. They were gaining some steam, had two great chances. The first 5 minutes, again, they could easily have four goals in this half. You had the shot hit the post. You had the one save on the PK. It's just been all Triton. They've dominated the play here in this second half. And the crowd is in it. The Trojan fans are here, are in it. The bench is into it as well. Who will be the hero today? 2-2. Brand new game. Battle for it. Kieta had it blocked. He had Alvarado on the outside, but it was blocked nicely and defended well there by Anoka-Ramsey. Richland will get the winner tomorrow. Long ball, Savarsky. It's blocked by Anoka-Ramsey. Wojcicki out to its center, headed out. Now outside, Reyes. And that long ball goes well wide of the net and out of play. So this game is, everything is turned in a hurry. Trojans looking to keep the pressure on. Battle for that ball. A lot of contact there. And now we'll see if there'll be a card issued or not. Alvarado went down. There'll be no card issue, but a free kick for Triton as we near 26 minutes left. Well, things are pretty boring for about the first 40 minutes or so of this one. So here's the free kick. Savarsky fires it, but well wide. So goal kick for Thompson. Good to see the president just walk in, Mary Rita Moore. Chairman's also now here for this. So maybe that's why the momentum's changed. Mark Stevens is down below. We've got a big day. We got basketball tonight as well here at Triton. Men's basketball opened their season this evening. So we have a lot of events going on here on campus today. Now, we'll see if things settle down a bit. Triton had to play with a lot of desperation trailing, but now you don't want to let up if you're the Trojans. So another good chance here for the Trojans. They're going to get a free kick here. We're under 24 minutes left. The Triton trail 2-0 at halftime. And have rallied. rallied in a fury in this second half. Safarski, a header! It's in! It's in! It's in! The Trojans have the lead! Michael Safarski, last year's All-American, he gives the Trojans the lead! Off the free kick, Safarski had the open runner and punched it in. 3-2 Triton. Oh, my. 3 goals in a 7-minute span for the Trojans. I said they are a quick strike offense, and the Lightning struck when they needed it. But now you got to finish the deal. You got to finish the deal here, and the Trojans looking to keep the pressure on. Again, Anoka-Ramsey has had absolutely nothing offensively in this second half. This whole second half has practically been played on the left side of the field. I don't think they've gotten a shot off in this second half. Well, how things have changed. Safarski, his 9th goal of the year. Unbelievable. Well, let's not stop. Like to add an insurance one. Alvarado near side, and that one goes out of play. Now, if you're the Trojans, you want to play possession, keep the ball away. But also balance it by maintaining the aggressive play to give you the lead. Alvarado to Reyes, he fires! Just a little high over the crossbar. Boy, but it was well struck by Didier Reyes right there. Be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. Richland awaits the winner tomorrow afternoon. It's been a tale of two halves today. Anoka-Ramsey the first half. The second half, it's been all Triton. And again, as we mentioned, they could have easily had a couple more goals in this half. Under 21 minutes to go. And there's an easy one that goes right to Thompson. So Anoka-Ramsey looking to find something here offensively, but again, they're going right into the teeth of a 20-mile-an-hour wind in this second half. Ball out ahead and cleared out nicely by the Trojans, by Sinanagic. 20 minutes remaining in the contest. 3-2 Trojans. And folks, just remember, it's only about 30-some-odd degrees out here, and we're outside. We don't have a luxury. We're not working in a luxury suite up here. We are enclosed, but we're still outside like everybody else. We don't have any heat up here either. No heat, no windows, no anything. 19 minutes to go. Trojans looking to seal the victory. Plus, remember, everyone, this is still the Triton College channel, so just remember that out there as well. We're supposed to cheer for Triton. Remember, that's who's paying my check. They won't even pay my check for about the last 20 years. That one goes out of play. But again, Anoka-Ramsey has not been able to generate anything on offense. Part of it's been because of how well Triton has played. Also, too, it is more difficult for them because they are going into the wind in the second half. But again, Triton has just been able to pretty much dominate all the play and have had much desperation. Down 2-0 at halftime. They've scored 3 unanswered here in the second half. Outside, Majewski looking, not able to maintain possession. Anoka-Ramsey able to take it away along the near side. Alexander had it, but he loses it back. And Guiano with it. Now a long strike ahead, and that will bound out a play, which really at this point is not a bad thing because it will be a goal kick for Thompson, but again, he has to go against the wind. He tried a low line drive one a couple of times, because anything that goes up high enough, the wind is just going to knock it down in this second half. And here's another one, and the wind just takes it down. But again, it's well defended by Triton to take control. Under 17 minutes left. Majewski with it. Going wide, cross, but no one home. He was looking for Pasula, but it was off target and out of play. Trojans going for their 19th win of the year. Their only loss was to Harper. They avenged it twice, beating them in the rematch in the regular season, beat them in the playoff game to win the regional title here Saturday. Down 2-0 here today. They've scored 3. We have an injured Trojan player, but for now they'll keep playing, no whistle. Chieta looking to get control. Now the ball comes back out. Triton does have it, still a player down, and now the whistle's blown. And we'll have a stoppage for the injury. 15:41 remaining here in the second half. 3-2, Trojans. That was Didier Reyes down for the Trojans, but back up. And now the clock will start again. And again, now you're up 3-2. Play ball possession. Kill as much of this clock as you can. But you would love to add one more for insurance. just to make things safe. It's still only a one-goal game, so a lot can happen here in this final 15 minutes. But it has been a very entertaining and exciting second half, I guess, for us. If you're watching in Minnesota, you may not agree. Yeah, I think so. Now this might be one of their better chances here. They finally have the ball to attack offensively, but again, it's headed out quickly by Triton, by Cole. Now the Trojans just need to play good defense here. Alexander, and that one punched out by Zafarski. Go Branson, far side. But again, well defended. Zafarski able to take it away. And again, they have not been able to get anything going here in this second half. Just, again, no shots on goal in this second half. Mojewski across, has a run! Boy, that was a wide open attempt for McCulloch. Had a great chance to potentially put it away, but was not able to get a clean shot off. We approach 13 minutes to go. Chieta, an easy stop for Thompson, gets it out ahead quickly. Again, Anoka-Ramsey now trailing. They have to be aggressive and try and push, take some chances. Good job here by the Trojans as time keeps on ticking. But you love to just get one more just to make it that much more difficult for Anoka-Ramsey. But give them credit. They came out here and they stunned the Trojans early. But Triton has woken up. They've come alive in this second half with three goals to take the lead. Alwanen lost it, but it's controlled by Triton. Chieta with space. Chieta out to Anguiano. Now it's Majewski with it. Chris, the cross, and goes out of play, and it'll be Thompson with a goal kick. Now Triton will go make some substitutions. That'll help kill some time off the clock. Majewski comes out. In the game is Jacob Kunrick. That'll just help milk a few precious seconds off the clock. As we're near 11 minutes to go. Anoka-Ramsey looking to generate something here. But that pass picked off. Listen, Adjic, he's had an outstanding game here for Triton. He's been all over the field. Goes down hard there. And they'll play on. Nothing called. And now the whistle blows, a stoppage for the injury. 10:29 remaining here in this second half. 3-2 Triton. The three goals were scored within a 7-minute span. Sinanchik got the first goal with about 31 and a half minutes left. Was a penalty kick. Then a minute and a half later, Chris Majewski, he scored to tie it. And then the Trojans took the lead, 3-2. Michael Safarski got the go-ahead goal, and right now, if this result stands, the potential game-winning goal for the Trojans. We near 10 minutes left, 10:09 and counting. 3-2 Triton. That's off target. Throw in Anoka-Ramsey. Again, the winner will get Richland tomorrow at 1:30 for the Midwest District Championship and the right to advance to the national tournament in New York. Down goes Maldonado Garcia. And Alexander will put it back into play for Anoka-Ramsey. 9.5 minutes left. Good tackle there by Sinanchik. Beautiful defense. Came in to time that tackle perfectly. It will be a throw-in for Triton. We're under 9 minutes and counting here in the second half. Trojans looking to milk this clock out and hang on for the victory. Again, Anoka-Ramsey is not recorded a shot on goal in this second half. They were up 2-0 at halftime. Alex Foreman in. Peter Suiva making the substitutions, taking advantage of them to waste more time off the clock, makes another one. That went out of play. It's going to go to Anoka-Ramsey. 8 minutes remaining. Trojans winding this down. Easily could have had a couple more goals in this half, but it appears if things stay the way they are that the three may be enough, but you love to add one more if possible. 7:30 in counting. There will be a goal kick for Thompson. Well, what a dramatic turn of events in this second half after being down 2-0. And I mentioned it in the first half. They have done this before. They did that against Elgin, their first game of the season. So, and they did it Saturday against Harper. This team has the comeback ability in them, but they got to finish it off this final. Now 7 minutes remaining. Clock winding down. That run out picked up easily by Triton, and it'll be kicked out towards center by Peter Paz. Again, Anoka-Ramsey has not been able to get much going in this second half offensively. Kieta has it. The run outside for Foreman, but it's cut off quickly by Maldonado Garcia. 6:28 in county. McCulloch with it. Now back to Mezek. Wind really picking up. and been gusting around upwards near 20 miles an hour consistently throughout this match. .550 and counting. Anoka-Ramsey with possession. But well defended there by Triton to force them back near midfield. Now the Rams will move it back a bit. Good play Alvarado there defensively to force the turnover. Kunrick with it. Out to Alvarado. Alvarado. And we'll see what the call will be here. Referee will help Alvarado up. No card, but a free kick for the Trojans. But while all this is going on, the clock keeps on running. We are down to 5 minutes remaining. For about 40 yards out, the free kick for the Trojans. Kieta. And it's headed out by Anoka-Ramsey. But Triton able to maintain control. Kieta fouled again. Kieta. Another free kick. Kieta curls it, but it's saved by Thompson. 4 minutes left. Trojans have played some lockdown defense in this second half. Cleared out by Bezek. Again, Anoka-Ramsey has to pick up the pace if they want to try and get the equalizing goal. Good defense again by Triton. That was again Zinanagic there. Gets control out to Foreman. And he clears it out ahead. And now Anoka-Ramsey controls under 3.5 to go. 3:21 and counting. Tackle. Taken over by Triton. Just looking to kill some more time. But it's taken away by Penner. But Kieta controls it for the Trojans. Kieta is dribbling, killing time. 2:55 in counting. Outside, Kudrat. But no one home in the center. And Anoka-Ramsey controls. But not for long. Foreman to Kieta. Kieta! A lot of contact there. He goes down. The Anoka-Ramsey player goes down. Nothing called, but Triton keeps control. And now the whistle blows. The clock will stop. 2:34 remaining. Second half. Triton 3. Anoka-Ramsey 2. So the injured player attended to. Well, for those of you who have just joined us, Anoka-Ramsey scored the first goal 4 minutes into the match. Felipe Barbosa, a long strike on a free kick for about 35 yards out. Nils Gulbranson scored 10 minutes later to make it 2-0 to Anoka-Ramsey. And then this second half has been all Triton. They had a ball hit the post, a shot hit the post in the first minute of the second half. An outstanding save by Devin Thompson off the first PK attempt the Trojans had in the second half. He saved that, kept it 2-0. But then Triton got another penalty kick opportunity as Arnell Sinanagic got the Trojans on the board. with 31 and a half minutes left. Chris Majewski tied it a minute and a half later. And Michael Safarski, with 24 minutes remaining, put the Trojans out in front. And now they're trying to hang on and preserve this lead. The clock will start, 2:30 and counting. 3-2 Triton. And a lot of contact there, and that has to be a card. Clock stops, and there it is, 2:13 to go, and there's the yellow card. That was pretty blatant right there. That was on Bobby, number 10, Carlos Bobby, so he will take a seat. Clock will start once the referee signals for play. And now he didn't blow his whistle, but just put the ball in play, but it is rolling. That goes into the corner. Will be a goal kick for Thompson. 2 minutes left. Can Triton complete the comeback? Defend for 2 more minutes and preserve the victory. Whistle. And now the clock will stop. 1:36 remaining. So we do have another Anoka-Ramsey player down. So Lucy Walsh, our trainer, out to attend to the injured Ram. Back up, it's Jordan Pierce. Actually, that's not Pierce, that's 19. That's Gail Talbay for the Rams of Anoka-Ramsey. And we thank everyone who's been watching on the YouTube channel. And we thank you all for your colorful comments throughout the stream. One 15 in the county. 3-2 Triton. Hanging on, looking to preserve this victory. Anoka-Ramsey again, still no shots on goal in this second half. 1 minute remaining. Mezick clears it out. Just got to play keep away here now. Deep ball ahead. Headed out of play by Anoka. Not quite out of play. Was kept in by Triton. 45 seconds left. Here comes the attack. Get Triton. You just need ball possession here. You don't need a goal here. Keep the ball down this end of the field and kill down the final 30 seconds. In the corner, they'll battle for it. Still battle for it. Again, that's just killing a lot of time. That really helps Triton. That's all that really matters at this point. It will be a goal kick for Anoka-Ramsey. We're down to 12 seconds left. They're going to have to hurry up. Thompson just taking his time, and that's going to do it, folks. We're down to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's over. The Trojans win. The Trojans win. Triton rallies from a 2-0 halftime deficit, and they defeat Anoka-Ramsey by the final of 3-2, and Triton will advance to the championship game tomorrow afternoon at 1:30 versus Richland.